Well, no, that's what I'm wondering. I'm not. All right, we're going clean, guys. Clean. We have to keep our.
Welcome for the very last time to Gann Academy. Basketball season 2023-2024. Glad I could bring you along this journey. This is my last game, senior night for the girls, and senior night for me as well. So, fun moment. I'm here with fellow senior, Laura Baker.
Hey, everybody. Glad to be here tonight with you.
And you've got
excited ties for the game, Brimmer.
You've got ties to one of the team players here for Gann.
Yeah, Alana Baker is my little sister. Not starting today. It looks like Abby is starting today, so shout out to her. A big senior night for all the seniors here.
Again, starting lineup, Nia Granite, Amalia McCoy, Abby Goldstein, Lexi Mason, and Gann Zoglo. Going with a heavy senior team to start here on senior night. For Brimmer, it's Kaylee Isivera, Hadley Reardon. Sorry, my mistake. It's Alexa Dykerman. We've got
13.
Maya
we got Maya Thompson. And we got Sophia Sampaio.
And going for the jump, we've got Yasmin Demeter.
Gonna be a good game. Gonna be a good game.
There's your starting five for both Gann and Brimmer. Play 8 minute quarters here. And Brimmer
and we're off. Brimmer wins the toss. All right. Alexa Dykeman with the ball, dribbling. Oh, and good defense by Gann Zoglo. Nice play, 25.
It would have also been nice if the clock operator, did his job.
Nice job, Ari Menzin, with the buzzer there.
That buzzer has been annoying all season, and that will be the one thing I will not miss leaving here tonight.
Hey, Brandon, do you have any other boys' games?
No, this is our final game here.
Home game? Oh, no.
The boys actually got two more games. One tomorrow at BTA, and then Thursday on the road to Chapel Hill. So, just down the road.
Number four, some tight defense by Lexi. All the way in. A little help. A bit of a shove by Lexi. They're going to call that foul.
Dykeman gets on the board first for Brimmer.
With an N1. Not him.
She knocked on the three-point play. It's again broadcast, so what's considered bias?
Oh, and they're pressing. You have to wonder, and Abigail's not looking in. A bit of a, all the way in. Amalia, all the way. And that's a foul, but no call. When she gets her own rebound, back up, off Brimmer. But they're calling it Brimmer ball. Interesting. I had a pretty good view. It looked like it was tipped to me.
You're going to learn here tonight. They're going to just
out of bounds. Chucked it up, number four.
They're going to miss a lot of those fouls. They like to let the kids play, the teams play, but.
Yeah, except they called another foul on again, so. It's just interesting. All right. Nice. Good play by Molly getting around. Being aggressive all the way. And no good. I thought that was also
way too strong off the glass for McCoy. Showing her speed and athleticism down the court.
Oh, off 22. Couldn't catch it, unfortunately.
Am I going to play that play?
Can we go?
Yeah.
You can go. Sorry, I felt like I was... Nina! Oh.
I'll read that. Okay.
How about that? You got it.
Dykeman, guarded by Mason, gives it off. Three-pointer, no good.
Come on, let's go,
Gann! No foul. Oh. They called a foul.
Maybe you should save your reaction to after the play.
Yeah. Brennan, if I'm talking too much, you can just let me know.
All right, great. I'll let you.
Brennan commands the box here.
Gann's funny. I never thought of it as kind of like a command center, but I guess that's kind of what it is. We control the broadcast here, what gets said, what doesn't get said.
It's true. Molly McCoy taking the ball up.
And we've got the best view.
Number four, looks like they're trapping. And they get it out to Nina. Nice catch, Nina. Malia, all the way in. Shot by Abby, and off the glass.
Couldn't go. I love the pass by Gann so far. And a low scoring game like this one, last week's game, even though it was a tough loss to Chapel
Number
Hill.
Number 4 has got hammered.
Gann still was playing great.
Number 22
catches. And was able to keep themselves in the game throughout the game. We'll see if that continues today. Full court press giving Gann trouble. I'll throw it back to you, Moore. What can Gann do to kind of avoid the full court pressure that Brimmer's?
Well, I feel like they've been doing a good job of it. You know, they're getting the ball. They're not holding onto the ball too long. Oop, I can hear that foul from over here, so you know that was a good call by the refs there. Anyways, trying to split the middle, maybe get the wings open. And you see the passing is pretty crisp and strong. So I think that's going to be how they're going to have to do that. I think also they're going to have to avoid letting the other team getting some offensive rebounds, maybe try to get a few for themselves. Ari Menton smiling at me.
Not a lip reader myself, but what I was gonna picture is he was trying to say shut up to you. But we'll just pretend we don't know what he's saying. I think it's probably a better thing we don't know what he's saying.
Yeah.
All right. Out of the break, here comes Brimmer.
I think Sabrina wants to share something. I mean, we have to save some room for the class president to say a couple words. So here, she's gonna say something about being a fan.
Women's basketball is the most incredible thing to ever happen. And you guys should all come up to every single game. This is incredible to watch. I feel riveted. I just feel amazing watching this. I feel energized. The players are amazing. They have a great team. I'll cede the floor back to Morgan.
All right, that's all the time we have for the president, unfortunately.
Couldn't catch that last basket by Gann. I think that was a Jess who scored. Molly, we'll check it out at the break after the quarter or halftime. But Gann taking the lead back here early on. 2:44 left to play.
Number 4 for the other team, Dykeman, wearing some mint green shoes, looking pretty cool.
I saw travel before the foul, but I guess that's not what the ref saw. That's the 5th foul on Gann this quarter. They'll head to Brimmer will head to the line to shoot 2. All fouls
called by the same ref. You gotta wonder.
It is the female official calling it down there.
The fans are happy that Sophia's putting number 23.
Are you as well?
Of course I am. I'm happy when anyone gets the chance to be on the floor.
Sports, what I love about sports, even in tough times, sports is what unites us all on and off the pitch.
You got that right, Brandon. You got that right. And just commentating with you, Brandon. I think also. Oh! Didn't look like she looked for that pass, but Amali was there. So. Back up! Oh! Oh, tough angle. Couldn't get the glass.
You're keeping me on the edge all the time. You keep saying, oh, but we'll see if it pays off for Gann. My NCC. Here she goes.
Cross her up to Amalia. And it's good! Should have been an and-one, but the ref didn't call it again.
We gotta stop on the and-one calls, though.
Oh, travel! Oh, 22 is reaching for her face. Feels like she got hit. But, of course, there was no foul. He's gonna be a little...
Nine figs.
So, Amalia. Good shot by...
No.
Won't go. Got to get back on defense.
And it's Dykeman the other way, guarded by DC.
I see my mother in the stands. So. very special that parents get to come and wrestle their kids. There was Diener Chodaker with a layup.
Brimmer wants to take a timeout. We'll take a break as well. Last minute here, quarter number one.
Getting my first lesson from Brandon on commentating here. It's more of a comment on a couple plays, not on the whole play-by-play, so I'll be working on that over the course of the game.
It takes time. The best of the best have done it for
and
years.
And my mom is taking a picture of me because she thinks it's funny that I'm commentating.
And I'll throw that back at you, which is...
you just mouthed
on the live stream, so you'll be able to go back and hear your commentating of you commentating yourself.
Makes me feel good that I'm getting a little attention for commentating.
4-3. Off and one. That won't fall.
Do we have a holdback coach for opposing team's coach? It's a real thing in football. When the head coach gets too far onto the field, they need a holdback coach to pull them back, make sure that they don't get a flag for being on the field too long.
Yeah, that's actually a really good thing. I'm seeing you hold on. We'll talk about it in the second quarter. About the
Jessica, by the way, oh! Blocked by 22.
Four out. No.
Go.
Count the bucket.
Nice, and it counted. 12-7 after the first quarter. Very high scoring game. We're back. Me and Brandon on the commentating. And I was suggested that I might read the rules for our viewer, for our singular viewer. But
I think our viewer will pass on that opportunity, but we
probably,
appreciate it.
Yeah. So yeah, I was.
There's a lot of rules.
Number five.
The girls' game that you wouldn't
get your own rebound.
Think about, but. Had a hold back with hair, that's one of them. We could go on and on. But boy, what can she do? Gets it back. Good ball movement by Gann. Almost lost it. ACC. We have a chaotic play. And it ends in a field goal. I don't think there's any other word than air ball that could sum that play up.
So you gotta admire Brandon for the way he toes the line between play by play, but not being too play by play, you know? And I can just see his mastery. And I appreciate that, Brandon.
I really appreciate it.
Oh! Number five, falling on the ground, shaking off the girls who are trying to help her up. Oh, shaking it off. Looks like she's a little rattled after that play. Looks like she's all right. You gotta wonder, was that Ari on the buzzer, or was that the other game on the buzzer?
I don't know. If you ever want to blame someone, you can always blame it on Ari.
You got that right, Brandon.
It's gonna stay Brimmer ball. They'll take it under the hoop.
Foul. 15. Good call by the ref. Love to see the Gann team smiling at each other.
Some paño.
They're pressing it. Gann ball.
Oh, I didn't know where that was going.
And the other team's... Oh. He forgot which way Brimmer was going. You could hear the almost very upset reaction from the crowd.
I'm wondering if I should just start holding my breath every time you say, oh, and we'll see how long I can hold my breath for. But I don't think that's what the viewers want, so...
So
we'll just go back to play-by-play.
I'm sensing that he doesn't like when I say, oh, before plays are over. Oh!
That was a long one. She just shimmies and shakes her way throughout the court. That's what makes her such a smart player. Here she comes, the floater!
I love the alliteration.
No.
Oh! Blocked by 15.
What Gann can do.
Looks like 22, Yasmin Demeter is coming back in.
Ion's pass almost gets intercepted by mistake and ball.
Tali Porath. Not Tali Porath.
Sophia Porath, shot, won't fall. Ion DC to clean it up. She's up to six.
No call there.
Steal by Gann. Let's see what they can do the other side of the court. McCoy.
Tried to save it, but it looked like it just bounced just out of bounds before she could save it.
Good effort, and here comes your sister, Lonnie Baker. Let's see what the freshman star can do. Dykeman, guarded by DC.
Oh.
That shot won't go. Here comes Gann.
Baker trying to get... Good call on the ref. Foul on number two. Malian Pierre. Foul on Amalia.
Rebound. Brimmer, third chance? No. Finally a rebound by Gann to stop that attack.
And you can see the Brimmer strategy to trap Amalia. Oh, buckets for Baker. Number 10. Her first shot, one for one.
Good math.
Thanks, Brandon. I needed my calculator. Oh, and a foul on Jessica. I didn't quite see the foul, though. Perhaps it was the hands to the face. Oh, and we're up to two views. Busy night tonight.
And that's two is double of one.
True. And I think last time there were, by halftime, like 8 viewers, maybe?
I don't know. The boys definitely get a lot more viewers than the girls game. We gotta
what
show
are
the
saying,
girls
Brett?
Some love. Second one falls. It brings it back to a 10-point game. 4:13 left to play.
Oh.
And court number two.
Bobbled by Baker. And a careless pass over the shoulder.
And Grant forgot. You got dribble.
A little it's harsh, okay. Brendan, huh?
It's okay. Getting some support by her coach. Telling her, don't worry, get back in there. Here comes Brimmer. It's all about those lessons you learn.
Oh, no good, because it hit the string thing hanging
hit the top.
From above.
Hit the top, it won't count. But
where in the rules does it say that? Let's see.
I don't know, maybe you'll spend the last 3 minutes finding it. Another travel, that's two straight turnovers for Gannon. Man, I wish I was keeping track of turnovers from the first quarter, as my fellow senior, Nadav Bornstein, once said, if I was tracking turnovers, it could be reaching double digits. And wouldn't be shocked if I see that again tonight. That's been...
Oh, and bobbled off of number two, and then bobbled off of Baker's hands, and then back to number two.
If
that
I
was
had
quite
a...
the...
Beckman's shot does fall. If I had pinpoint one theme from both of these teams throughout the season, it would be the turnovers.
Brandon, that's a little bit harsh. Oh, and Baker looking, but getting a timeout. They called a timeout to save Baker from that trap. She didn't know what to do. You can see that she's signaling with her shrug. I didn't know what to do. See that.
You could say harsh, but I think the reason why I bring it up is it came up a lot. And being able to hold on to the ball in basketball, it's very vital. It's not a big field like you've seen other sports, soccer, football. And it's similar
Brandon,
to a sport like hockey.
You thinking of expanding this commentating gig to some maybe soccer or of the sorts?
That's funny you ask. We're actually in the midst of working on a project. The only problem is it comes with a lot of funding. I don't have that money. But
maybe give a shout out to the athletics department. Maybe we could get a little Gann bucks in there. Oh, Jay, but Abby. Oh.
The goal is to build the brand, as you say, and to not just broadcast basketball, maybe get to volleyball, baseball, lacrosse, soccer.
Baseball? I don't know if there's enough action in baseball for it to be as fun.
I may actually scrap that idea, and I think I'm going to scrap that idea. It's too slow.
You know, if I could commentate soccer, I'd have a lot of fun with that.
It would be, and I wouldn't count the idea of coming back next year, even during the winter time. But,
yeah.
We'll see.
Locked by 22. Getting back on defense is Granick, but missed the layup, number 15, but hustling back. Out of bounds, forced out of bounds. What's the call there?
Push.
As I believe number 15 pushed Mason out. So pushes the ball.
I think that's the third on Sampaio. Oh. hopefully pronounced that correctly. Here comes Mason. See what she can
up
do.
Up to three views. Looking good for us tonight. Off. Off is Zagma. Might have been tipped. Granick wants it. And it'll go! Granick! With a two-pointer. Off the glass.
Buzzagolo. No.
All the seniors want one tonight. I believe Rennick, Mason, and Goldstein all have. Rennick with a steal. A careless pass up the middle. And let's see. Oh, crossover. Oh. Double travel.
I think you could have called double dribble as well. She picked it up after she, or started dribbling after she picked it up again. Either way, it's another turnover for Gann.
You gotta commend the refs for making it all the way up here at a 5:30 p.m. Monday afternoon. Seriously. Oh, AJ, going to help out. During cross-country season, I remember I frequented her office often.
Many players like to see her throughout the game.
Brennan, you thinking of expanding this to maybe cross-country?
Cross-country, no.
Hard no.
I already said that was off limits to me. That was the first one I think I already rejected.
Oh, that was the first one.
And the reason why is you guys just move around too much that you wouldn't be able to have one concrete camera unless you want to get someone on a
moving
camera.
That's a good point. That is a good point. We're just too fast.
You really are. Coming to a close for this first half.
I still see 23 seconds.
A comfortable lead. Let's see if they can add more points.
Rennick was looking for it. Looking up at the board. I'm not sure what she was looking at there, but 22, won't go. A lot of opportunities for 22. Some tight defense. And it's halftime, and before we go, I just have to ask Brandon, what do we think about some, maybe, poetry during halftime for our viewers? Some Shakespeare sonnets, maybe?
I don't think any of our viewers want that, including Ari Menzies who's coming over.
It's we're going to turn it off quickly before Ari Menzies can get a chance.
We'll be right back.
Does this mean it's on or not?
Yeah.
Fifty seconds till we're back. And Ari Menza wants a little guest appearance. I don't know what he could say, but let's hear it. No, you can lean in.
Yeah, pretty good game so far. I've seen a lot of desire from Gann. I think it was Paul Pierce that said it's all about desire. And he was absolutely right about that. Don't you think, Brandon?
Well said.
Thank you.
Well said.
Yeah, yeah. They don't give me enough credit.
And I think it was Michael Jordan who said, it's really all about who has more points at the end.
No. He didn't say that. My glow wasn't made up. Yours was. You have no ball knowledge. You disgusting. You credible.
Please.
Great,
please. I watched The Last Dance. I have plenty of ball knowledge. And I think now it's time to share a little bit about the Brusher Games. Sponsoring this game is the Brusher Games. I am currently in. I've gotten one kill. I have two toothbrushes that I carry with me everywhere. Basically, it's a big group game of assassin with the whole school, where you have to brush someone with a toothbrush in order to get them out. I managed to get Zach Wasserman. I had to look him up in the directory so I could know his face.
What grade is he in?
I believe a 10th grader. I believe a 10th grader. No, he's a 10th grader. Juliana's correcting me and saying that he's a freshman, but I wouldn't be too sure about that.
It also wouldn't shock me if you found the wrong person.
No, I got the right guy. I saw his face, so that's good. Good defense by... Good... Oh. No good. Oh, number. It's 22, and the coaches are happy about that one. And a little bit of cowbells, similar to the ones you might hear at the marathon. Backcourt, Abigail. So basically, the thing
well,
with that rule.
Turn over to the tally.
Well, so the thing with that rule is that if you go over the middle line, you're not allowed to then pass the ball back. Across the middle line, because that would be considered a backcourt violation. Backcourt, hence passing it.
Look at you getting right into it early on.
Rebound. Oh, and a 3 from 55. She's pumped about that one. She is pumped. We got 6 viewers. We're up to 6 views. Unfortunately, 0 concurrent viewers right now. But.
Maybe it's for a good thing.
Abigail. Oh! Almost. Won't go. Good hustle by the ref getting down.
Rebound! Rebound! Rebound!
He's got his whistle in his mouth ready to call, make a call.
One of the best broadcasting tips I think I've heard over the years.
Good hustle by the ref.
Understanding when to commentate and understanding when to just.
Tipped off by number 15, Sophia Sampai. Unfortunately, she just tips that out. No.
And I think there's certain conversations that just should not be mentioned on a broadcast. So, that being said, I think we're going to move on. Here comes Mason. She drive won't fall.
Good hustle by the ref again. I'm liking the hustle.
Brimmer drives. Shot too strong.
Oh, and almost a turnover, but Zaglo, out of bounds. Dang it.
I think that was 3 seconds I held my breath for. We should start a timer, see how long I can hold my breath for.
Yeah, Brandon, let's see how long you can hold your breath for. I'd like that.
Thank God we're above water, not below water.
Thank God. And a good call by the ref there. Oh, doesn't look like the coach is. So I think the thing with the rule there is that you're not allowed to run up to someone and then do a pick while you're moving. So I think the call there was a moving pick, which you're not allowed to do. You can only set a pick if you're stationary.
Spot on analysis by the Baker. Boy.
Abigail. Gets her own.
Well, it's good effort there by Goldstein, the senior, but won't fall. Brimmer.
Another three. Five is feeling lucky.
Brimmer has cut the lead down to one. 22 looks like she's starting to put some buckets in the hoop. And the pressure. I believe we can bounce back. I believe we can. We as in Gann. And for, I am a little bit biased.
It is a Gann broadcast, so one thing I did also learn this summer, I'll shout out and join my program at Syracuse Newhouse School of Communications, but one thing I did learn was when you're broadcasting, you're not part of that we. Because you're not part of the team. But here at Gann Academy, as a student, we are part of that team. And united on the court is what we do here. Jess, her shot
some
scored.
Good passing. It's a tough finish to put that ball in the hoop.
Travel will go Gann's way.
Appreciating this ref.
It's not really serious.
Doing a really, really good job.
Here comes the full court press.
And you just he's trying his hardest. And, you know, emotions run high, and I don't think the refs get enough credit for the amazing work that they do. It's really hard to see every single play.
As a, we like to call grass, which means youth level, regional youth level for soccer referee. I do appreciate when the fans and the coaches understand that us refs aren't perfect, and we see that here in basketball.
You got to pass that in, and the rule there is that you have to pass it in within 5 seconds, I believe. You can see the ref counting off from the sideline.
The NBA rule applies here at the high school level. Brimmer for the lead no. Rebound Mason. Here she comes.
All the way, all the way. Oh.
DC
a little
can't fall.
Too hard up the good defense by Amalia. Oh, good. Good steal. Clean steal. Another steal. Let's see if they can put it. Oh, tried to put it up light. Lexi was looking for a call there. Shout out to Juliana Vegas for keeping the score with us on online. For our one concurrent viewer out there, thank you for being with us. We've gotten 6 total views, and yeah, it's just truly great to have you.
Not sure if you can hear that on the broadcast, but that cowbell is for you, our one concurrent viewer. Gann, down, Somalia, not to go.
Amelie. 24 for Gann. That's a 2. Now, for our one concurrent viewer, if I could call you in, I'd ask you, would you prefer a play-by-play or more of like a every now and then we give us give some insight. Of course you can't answer because we have no way of hearing you. But it's great that you're here. They can comment.
Brimmer's unhappy. They'll take a timeout. We'll take one as well.
whistles are going on, and it looks like we're trying to come back.
We are back.
Our mics are back on.
We are back, I guess.
We're back.
Gann's lineup consists of Mayan TC, Amelie, Amalia, Sophia Pora, and Jess. If I'm not mistaken, it's an all-junior lineup for Gann. Let's see what they can do. Final 250 left to play in corner number three.
On the ground, call by the ref. Getting a little too handsy with the defense there, but. I just touched the ball.
Good hands.
Oh my god, I just touched the ball, everybody. For our two concurrent viewers, the ball just rolled over to me. I touched it, and I handed it back to the ref. And I'm very proud of myself.
Okay, so we all know now that Maor Baker will not be washing his hand for the next 24 hours. So if you want to high-five his right hand, you can touch the ball as well.
Good team. Seven total views, two concurrent viewers, and it looks like we're getting a crowd here. Thank you, everybody, for watching. I wish we could get a chat going, but unfortunately there's no comment section. Unless there is, and we're just missing it. The mic can pick it up. Mom, I'm doing My mom is totally embarrassing me right now. My toothbrush just fell on the floor.
It still picked it up. A little careless there.
The ball almost came to me again. It's like
magic.
We have two viewers. My mom is asking, are there viewers? Yes. Two concurrent viewers, seven total views.
Offensive foul. Go the opposite way.
22 is getting subbed back in.
That's the third on McCoy. Speaking of McCoy, she gets the rebound.
McCoy gets the rebound. 4-point game, very close. Oh, and a crisp pass. It's up, and it's good. Jessica Klebonnership, another basket.
She's up to six.
And the lead. As Brandon said, yes.
Both Gansley is six, and also Jessica has 6 points today. A little confusing right there. Leon, go for the steal. She gets it.
She gets it. No call.
Everyone just waited around like there was going to be a foul call.
No foul call. Pass it out to Amalia. Oh, and a fake. Oh! An incredible move by McCoy. And another steal. We don't even need a hold.
The other end, Gann can't get it. It falls. Let's see what Brimmer can do last 50 seconds.
Nine total views.
Here comes Alexa Dykman.
Has more than
she'll shoot for three.
Our views has more than tripled since the beginning of this game. So. Thanks, all our fans, all our watchers. Thanks for having me.
We actually get a lot more fans after the game. They like to watch the replay of it. So we really appreciate you guys, even if you're not here live. Still can catch the game. McCoy!
A little Trey Young move there. My
DC
favorite.
Knocks it down, no.
Lead is back up to 10.
Gann, lead.
20 seconds left. 10-point game lead.
9 from DC.
Good defense. A lot. Oh, 15.
And then jump will go Gann's way.
Looks like they're doubling McCoy.
And you gotta wonder, somebody must be left open if they're doubling.
Well, it didn't work there. Brimmer's gonna try one more chance. There was a double dribble before the buzzer sounded.
And the buzzer, another one from Ari. Thanks for the buzzer, Ari Menzin. Thanks for the buzzer.
10-point Gann lead. We'll be back with the fourth quarter.
Stay with us, two concurrent viewers. We're having a lot of fun with you. During that break, we were just discussing the Brusher games yet again.
It's a good thing I wasn't in charge of making it, because Juliana's
gonna
have something else to name it.
Juliana's gonna join us for a bit in the final quarter of the game, if she has something to say. She's totally welcome.
Off and gone!
She's sitting right behind me the whole time.
Fouled.
Keeping score. Very important work out here.
Foul will go against Kaylee Izzy-Vera. This Brimmer team is not making my life easier with some of this challenging pronunciation.
You gotta wonder, you come from a Jewish school, you see a lot of challenging names, but still, you know.
Yeah, but the hyphen in it can kind of shorten it, like my aunt just calling her DC. Easier than
fair.
Saying the full name.
And an offensive rebound from
McCoy can't get anything to go on that rebound. Dykeman shield
and
lay
another
off.
Two, but won't go.
Izzy Vera's shot won't fall. Mason waving. Short. Everything but the finish was there.
Shout out to Gabe Friedman for going to practice today.
I was told he did not play in the boys' senior night game, who's still injured. Or sick.
Sick.
Sick is the illness I was told.
Sick in quotations, I say.
I got five.
Yeah. Well.
Juliana assures us he was sick.
I think we should end this conversation, or it'll get worse for us.
Yeah, true, Brendan.
Dykeman's shot will fall. Oh, it looks like a clean block there. They're about to say no.
They're gonna call the foul. And see if she can.
It's McCoy's fourth.
Let's see if we can get to double-digit total views by the end of the year. By the end of the stream.
And Coach Jason not taking any chance.
I know that people want to.
He's going to take out Amalia. She's not happy about it, but I think it's the right decision. It is a 10-point game, but there's plenty of time for Brimmer to come back.
So, Brandon, could you just explain the rule there, why they might want to take Amalia?
Coach, for you, the assistant coach, we should not hear from you. All right? Just the head coach. I don't want to hear you.
The rule is, I'm pretty sure if I'm not mistaken, five fouls and you're, what they call is fouled out for the game. That one looks like it went off against Leon. That's her second.
A lot of chirping coming from the bench there.
Demeanor gets the first one to fall. two-point game. 6:49 left to play. Playing time. I'll explain again. They want to preserve Amalia.
My mom is leaving.
In case.
Bye, Mom.
In case this game does get a little closer, then Gann will want.
Juliana's going to get in on this first.
They'll want to keep Amalia for the down the stretch. So, we've got six and a half minutes left, basically. It is an 8-point game, which is not much for this girls' team. What does Gann do to finish strong?
You might have to talk a little closer. Maybe we can hold out this last 6 minutes and 49 seconds of quarter four.
I know it is 4 quarters that they play, but the last part of each quarter is kind of feels like that fourth quarter mentality. And let's see what they can do.
Oh!
Shot won't fall. It was good decision, good ball movement by Gann there. Dykeman on DC. For shot, no. Rebound.
Oh, bobbled.
She's unfortunately, she can't hold on to it. Well, it'll go out for a game ball. Full court press, no problem for Gann.
That opposing team's coach and says, yeah, it was a travel this time. I thought it was a flying call. I saw the feet moving, but... Oh. Sometimes you just got to remember, it's a high school women's basketball game. It's a question. Question from the coach. Maybe we'll have to look at the rule book here. Maybe we need some replay. Maybe we need some. Shouldn't dribble. Not sure what's going on here. Coach is.
The refs are talking over. We'll take a break as well.
And we're back from the break.
Wait,
and it's
wait.
White ball? No, we're not. 6 minutes, 11 seconds.
Not sure how that's rumor ball, but we play on.
Juliana's getting it back on. Loaded question from Juliana. Let's hear what Ben has to say.
First game, shock us through. Love it, but I'll answer the question in a second, which is, no matter what, the coaches should not be influencing the end of the game. It's been a great game, as you've seen tonight, and you would hate for it to have implications based on influences by coaches. It doesn't matter for Gann.
Thread the needle pass there from Wiener Trotiker.
She finds Jess.
On her shift with a layup.
There's Lexi with the steal. Up to a 12-point lead. She looks like she got fouled on that three. Second chance for Gann. Rebound. Pour out. From three. No. Up to 10.
Well, double digits for Demeter.
And we are still not on double digits in terms of views. So, encourage your friends to encourage viewers. Encourage your friends to get on.
Four straight unanswered points for Brimmer. That calls a timeout for Gann.
We'll take a quick break. And we're back. Almost at 10 views. 4 minutes and 17 seconds left to go.
McCoy. She gets fouled. Finds McCoy. Her drive won't go. Rebounded by Brimmer. Let's see what they can do the other side of the court. Dykeman! Can't answer. Mason. She's gonna drive. The distance. She scores.
Senior night. It's a special night. We're up by 10.
We did it.
Exploded.
We did it.
Just exploded.
We did it.
To 11.
We did
11. We did it.
Let's go.
Double, not only 10, but double digits. We're up to 11. And unfortunately, you couldn't get our full reaction because we had to be quiet for the free throw.
Well, one of us is.
Now that they're done with the free throws, we just got 11 views. That is double digits, one more than 10.
Good math.
You know, Brandon, there's no one I'd rather do it with. Oh! The ball is tipped out, almost hits Ari Menzel. You can see a look of surprise on his face from that, almost getting whacked in the face by that ball.
That looked like it was off Brimmer, in my opinion.
But, of course, opinions aren't biased, are they?
Or the only opinion that matters is the refs. I like to say, ball don't lie. There we go. Ball didn't go in because of that. McCoy, to
they're
bring
almost,
it up.
They're looking like they want to triple McCoy. A strong pass from McCoy. Oh.
Just no. It won't fall for her this time. 3:18 left to play. Gann up 8.
Oh! And one. You gotta wonder, was it on the floor or was it not on the floor? They're gonna go discuss that for a second. And I do not want to see the opposing team's coaches.
Two shots.
Two shots on the floor.
Basket's good.
One shot, one shot.
She'll try for a three-point play.
You gotta wonder, were the coaches influencing that decision at all?
Oh, yeah. Jump ball, go Gann's way, and we're very fortunate here.
3:11 to go, and Brandon, I gotta wonder, the clock stops now. Why wasn't it stopping earlier?
I think we had a clock issue.
Who's on clock, Brandon?
I do not know. you're blocking my view. Thank you. Got my eye with the two?
We're up to 13 views, everybody. 13 views.
Brimmer can't answer the other way. Let's see what Gann can do. McCoy. She's going coast to coast. We got a double dribble.
Up to Jessica, and it won't go, but offensive board.
Great board.
I love the hustle by Gainer Chalker.
Two minutes remaining. 8-point Gann lead. Let's see if they can hold on. Dykeman can't get it. Go. Here comes Mason.
Frustrated coach.
Jess will try for the two, no. No good.
Good hustle by the ref once again.
And I actually wish Gann kind of slowed it down, slowed up the pace. Thankfully that shot won't go.
Now there's three people behind. Oh!
Double team, triple team, nothing can stop McCoy.
Quiet.
There she is on the ball. She's gonna drive.
Nice buzzer by Arthur. Oh, another one. Another one.
And
what
here
the
comes
heck
the two
is going
senior
on.
Captains for Gann. Abby
Goldstein.
Another
one.
Blue Oslo. Join the mix.
Wow. How many
and
of those
Lexi
buzzers
Mason
are going to go off?
On the court. The senior is getting to finish it off. Let's see. Can they hold on? But first, they'll
go.
Need to defend. 1:12 left to play.
1:12 left to play, and the seniors are on the court. You got to commend the coach for putting them out on senior night. A wonderful game for Gann, but it's still an 8-point game. Foul. Oh. Elbowed in the head by one team.
That's McCoy's fist, and she has fouled out.
Here you go, Abby. I had to turn off my mic for a second to cheer on my friends. Oh, timeout. Timeout red?
Timeout Gann.
Very quiet audience, so. Looks like a little break. Yeah, we.
Absolutely not. As
we would not like another
says,
buzzer.
We want the buzzer. We do not need the buzzer. Brimmer's gonna shoot.
Okay, you
too.
Gotta commend Ari Menzin for being on the buzzer. So. Wow. It is
Ethan 14.
We're up to 14 views.
Dude, we
incredible.
Had three at the end of the first quarter.
So I have to say I've been saying that Ari Menzin's been on the buzzer this entire time, but really it's been Ethan Porath. So let's give credit where it's due.
Yeah, I think
buzzer.
If I'm not mistaken, Ari Menzin's on shot clock.
Ah, a much less important role.
I would have to differ, but what have you liked so far today, if I can?
What have I liked? You know, I like the ball movement. I think the ball movement has been pristine. And Juliana's going to answer that question if we can get her. Freaking break from that buzzer. Dang.
I like the teamwork of
Gann. Short and go. Right above the audience. 6-point game. 58 seconds.
58 seconds in time. Stop the play.
Do we have
defense
to be nervous?
That's what.
Where is McCoy?
Say.
Did McCoy foul out?
Yes. Her fifth foul, she fouled out.
Yes. Oh,
go. Second chance, no.
Get that board.
Yes. Third time. Oh, yes. Four point Gann, lead.
Yes. time out by blue, by red. There is no blue, unfortunately.
We'll take a break.
We are back, and we're up to 15 views. This is incredible. Three concurrent viewers. Oh, no, a foul.
Mason loses it.
Hustle back, good defense by Jeff.
Mason, she's weaving and waving. Just a double fall.
White ball. 4-point game, 25 seconds to go. Another timeout. You gotta wonder, how many timeouts do both teams have?
I was asking about the game specifically. Oh. Analysis. What are your thoughts about the game?
Well,
heated to say the least.
Ari Menzin.
There we go. Bayon with the steal.
An incredibly important steal.
That looked to me like red ball.
I agree.
But nobody cares your opinion, Ari. We only care the ref's opinion.
No one cares about mine either.
No one cares about Brandon's opinion either. That Terry call was atrocious. You gotta give it to the Brimmer coach. He was right about that.
Whoa. Oh, we're down to two concurrent viewers ever since Ari joined us, so maybe Ari should stay a little bit out of this.
Or as I like to say, foul or not, I don't know if that was a foul or not, so it was a mess. Let's see if she can make the second.
Let's see if she can get some redemption here, Brandon. No, she cannot. I called her before she even. Yep.
14. And number 15 gets what she did to Abby at the very beginning. Thrown to the ground.
The Brimmer coach says, I respectfully disagree with that call, but at the end of the day, you're the ref, so I'm going to respect your opinion.
I wonder if this might up Ari.
And I'm having a great time.
Ethan Porath on the buzzer.
I was thinking about giving this a nickname, and I think we should call it the whistle game, because there's been way too many whistles so far today.
Yeah, at least like five or six.
I think five or six too. Just in this last minute.
Yeah, so probably like at least like 10 in the
off the front rim, still a 4-point game.
In the quiet grand Gann crowd is too much for the Brimmer player to handle on this free throw.
Yeah, she's going to miss this one.
Thank you, Brandon, for the rules. And you just gotta notice four free throws. It's a 30, it's a 4-point game. Four free throws that unfortunately were missed for the other team. 5, 4, 3.
They don't need to shoot.
Out of bounds.
Out of 2, all Gann needs to do is inbound it, and it'll be a senior night victory.
Senior night victory, yes!
I think Brimmer has a chance on this one.
But
all they need is an and one on a 3.
He really wanted to see
the
guy.
And one on a 3. And 3, one on a three. Come
three
on.
Concurrent viewers. The game is over. Senior night wins.
And Coach Brimmer says, hey, quick
we
game,
are
guys.
Very, very,
by the ref.
Very, very happy for Gann here today, because a senior night win means everybody is happy. You can see Jess is happy, Mayan is happy,
and
Abigail's happy, Nina's happy.
As my parents used to tell me during my childhood, Good Night Moon. That was my favorite book.
We might be saying Good Night Moon in a second, but first we just have to say, to close us out, thank you, Brandon, for having me today. I hope you enjoy. I hope all the concurrent viewers enjoy. Thank you for 15 total views. That is a double digits, even subtracting mine, Juliana's, and Brandon's views. So good for us. 3 concurrent viewers. Thank you for being here tonight. And good night, Moon. As Ari says, Brandon,
I'll
you got any
us.
Final?
I'll end us.
Can I just introduce you for a second?
Sure.
This is Brandon's final commentating gig of
the
year.
No, they're hosting playoffs.
Unless we host playoffs.
Which is going to happen.
Which is going to happen. So you just got to say, Brandon, for a final regular season, Brandon, any last words? You've been an incredible commentator.
Thank you. I wanted to say thank you to you guys. Thank you to Juliana. Thank you. Biggest thank you going out to Brad Ballinger, the Gann Academy Athletic Director. None of this would be possible without the support he does. Also, want to give a shout out to IT, Andy from IT, who's setting all this up for us. We thank you for setting up this live stream, because without you, we would not be able to give you guys, the fans at home, this much deserved broadcast. So, we've enjoyed the season.
And a shout out to Ari Mensley also. Because
no shout out to Ari. Thank you, Brandon.
Is so great.
Let's just say good night, Moon. Over and out. 38-34 final score.
Signing so, to play some Call of Duty tonight.